You should take one class. Very nice, Bhuvan. Thank you very much. Shreetan. Okay, Aditya is done. Who wants to speak? Pranav, Kavita Mataji, I can't see your video. Can you switch on the video? Shreetan, yeah, you can speak. You switch on the video and then.
Okay. Oh, my name is Shreeta. I'm in fourth grade. And I know that in Bhagavad Gita.
I cannot see you, Shreeta.
I know that in Bhagavad Gita. I was going to ask Krishna.
Hold on. Pranav, who is this? Shreeta, yeah. I think I can see 2-3 screens. Yeah, Shreeta, yeah. You are in fourth grade, yes, and?
I was going to ask Krishna to take him to the battlefield. And when he saw all his friends and relatives, he didn't want to kill them. So Krishna tells him that he must and...
Yeah.
And...
Krishna told him that he must fight, right? And the reasons why he has to fight.
I wanted to say.
Very good, Shreetan. Shreetan, you have an outline of Bhagavad Gita. I like it. Thank you very much. Okay. And now Pranav.
Bhagavad Gita, the whole thing. And,
yeah, song Bhagavad Gita. Yeah. Pranav, can you please switch your video on? Yes. Now you can speak, Pranav.
Okay, so my name is Pranav, I'm in 6th grade, and my interests are playing piano, and I don't know anything about Bhagavad Gita.
You don't know about Bhagavad Gita, that's not at all a problem. We are here all to learn about Bhagavad Gita, but that's fine. Bhagavad Gita is a conversation between Krishna and Arjuna. And why Krishna is speaking, why Arjuna is listening, why we all have to study Bhagavad Gita, we will discuss everything here. Pranav, you can keep your video on so that we can get used to each other. Okay, Radhya is here. Radhika and Hansika.
My name is Radhika and I'm in 6th grade. And I know Bhagavad Gita means songs of the God. And also, I think Sri Ganesh, I think he wrote down all the verses.
Ganesha wrote all the verses. Okay, good job. Very nice. Hansika.
My name is Hansika. I am in third grade and I know there is 700 verses.
Wow. You know that there are 700 verses. And out of 700, Hansika is going to learn at least 108 verses by the end of the year. I mean next year. Okay, Hansika. Is that okay? Fair deal? Okay, good job. Thank you. Satya Bhama. Satya Bhama, go ahead.
I just know a little bit.
Satya Bhama and Radhya are of same age. Satya Bhama, you tell first your name.
I am Satya Bhama. I am in kindergarten.
You are in kindergarten.
And all I know about Bhagavad Gita is that Krishna was the driver of Arjuna's chariot.
Oh, Krishna was the driver of the Arjuna's chariot. Very nice. That's the picture what is there on Bhagavad Gita, right, Satya Bhama?
Yes.
Yeah, Krishna is such a big personality and he's driving the chariot for Arjuna. What's the secret? Let's all know the secret why he's driving the chariot, okay? Thank you very much, Satya Bhama. Keshav, you can unmute yourself. Satya Bhama, you can mute yourself. Keshav, I can't hear you.
Hear us. Can you hear us now?
Yes, Mataji. Yeah.
All right. So, my name is Keshav. I'm in fifth grade.
I did like two Bhagavad Gita competitions.
Mm.
I know some things about Bhagavad Gita, not all. Mm.
Yes.
I'm still.
Yeah. Thank you, Keshav. I heard you have memorized some of the chapters of Bhagavad Gita also. It's very nice to know about you through your mom. It's very interesting. Nobody knows everything about Bhagavad Gita. Nobody can know everything about Bhagavad Gita. Kids, remember one thing. Nobody can know everything about Bhagavad Gita. Because Bhagavad Gita is spoken by who? Bhagavad Gita is spoken by Krishna. Who is Krishna? He's the Supreme Personality of the Godhead. And his knowledge is vast. Even Arjuna couldn't understand everything of Bhagavad Gita, right? So we have to be always open-minded, saying that I don't know, I want to learn. Then only we can learn. If we say that I know about Krishna, I know about Arjuna, I have been seeing this orange color book since I was born, then it won't go into our heads. Okay? So we have to be really open-minded to accept the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Okay? So anybody has any doubts, I'm able to see you all your screens. You can raise your hand or unmute yourself and say, okay, here one way of addressing me is Mataji. You can call me Mataji. Mataji means motherly role. Okay, I'm not your mother, but like mother. Teacher is like a mother. So you can call me Mataji and then address if you have anything. Or teacher, you can say whatever. My other, one of the Bhagavad Gita kids class batch calls me BGT. Okay, what, do you know what is BGT? Bhagavad Gita teacher. It's a short form they made and they say, BGT, we have this question, BGT. Because virtual classes, right now all the classes, so they call me BGT, BGT, address me. So whichever way, Mataji, you can call teacher, you can call whatever, whoever is comfortable with whatever. Okay? And now we'll get an introduction class. This class will be totally an introduction class about Bhagavad Gita. Okay? Whoever can write. I know Radhya cannot write. I know Satyabhama cannot write. But whoever can write, make the points. This will help you make the points. There will be some points which you know. There will be many points which you don't know. But if you make a note of them, it will be easy for you to do the revision of the class. Is that okay? Do you all know my name first of all? Who don't know my name? Okay, Pranav might not know my name. Radhya, you don't know my name? You said you are from temple. You see me every week in the temple.
I know your name.
You know my name. Okay, good. Wonderful. Okay, Radhya will tell my name, okay, to everybody. Radhya, what is my name? Radhya? Srimati Mataji, yeah. My name is Srimati Kids, so you can call me Srimati Mataji. Thank you, Radhya, for introducing me. So my name is Srimati. I am Srimati Mataji. I will be teaching you Bhagavad Gita for next 1 year, every week, one class. Okay? This is not at all going to be a stressful class. Because if we have stress, we cannot understand about God. Okay? God worship, God reading, God understanding is never a stress. Okay? So, we will be reading about Bhagavad Gita detailedly. I miss Janki. Janki, can you switch on your video and introduce yourself? Janki, Poonam Mataji, Hridya. Okay, Hridya, you can unmute and introduce yourself. Then Janki will.
Hare Krishna, my name is Hridya. I'm 5 years old and
Hridya is 5 years old. Hridya, what do you get into your mind when I speak about Bhagavad Gita?
I don't know.
What do you think when I say Bhagavad Gita? When mom said that Srimati Mataji is going to take Bhagavad Gita classes, what did you feel like? What is Bhagavad Gita about?
About Krishna.
About Krishna, of course. And? Who else is there?
Arjuna.
So we are going to learn what Krishna has spoke to Arjuna, yes?
Yes.
Very good, Vidya. Very nice. Who else is there? Did I miss anyone? Janaki is missing. Janaki, Poonam Mataji, can you video and Janaki? Yeah. Wow, Janaki, you grew so big. You were a baby. Krishna was like you when he joined me. Janaki's brother Krishna was there with me for the Bhagavad Gita classes 5 years back. Oh, Janaki. Okay, thank you, Haridya. Janaki, you introduce yourself, your age, your grade, and then, yeah, go ahead.
My age is 10 years old, and I'm in fifth grade.
You are in fifth grade. What do you know about Bhagavad Gita, Janaki? You know many things, I know, but whatever, little bit you can share with us.
I forgot some of the stuff.
You used to be a small baby and used to read Bhagavad Gita with your brother. I remember. It's about Krishna and Arjuna conversation, yes? Yes, okay, okay. Okay, feel comfortable. No, no obligation at all. Okay, good. We have lot of kids here. Bhuvan is here. Satyabhama is here. Shritan is here. Krishna is here. Pranav is here. Aditya is here. Hansika, Radhika, Keshav, Janaki, Hridya, Rujula, Radhya. Very good. Very wonderful. Okay. Is everybody audible? Is my voice and video both clear to all? Show the thumb. Hridya, yes? Okay, okay. Everybody is happy. Janaki, yes? Clear? Okay. So now you all kids mute the calls, because if you make some sound also, it's going to resound to me and everybody will get disturbed. So everybody mute your calls. Whoever wants to speak can unmute. First raise your hand and then I'll say your name and then you can unmute. Okay? Okay, Bhuvan? Good? We are good? Okay. Shritan, good? Okay, good. Okay. So first thing is, some of your kids have told about what is the definition of Bhagavad Gita. When I said that, what do you know about Bhagavad Gita? Couple of students told something Bhagavad Gita definition. Anybody wants to let me know what does Bhagavad Gita mean? Raise your hand and then I'll let you know if you can speak. Bhagavad Gita. Some people have told, some kids, couple of kids have told. Yes, Radhika.
Songs of the God.
Song of the God. Very good. Now, let's split this word Bhagavad Gita. Okay? Gita, song, as Radhika has said. Bhagavad Gita means song of the God. So, where does this word come from? Bhagavad. Okay? Satyabhama, listen carefully. Shritan, Pranav, everybody. Bhagavad comes from the word Bhagavan. Okay? Bhagavan means God. Bhagavad means of the God or from the God. So Bhagavad Gita means song of the God or song from the God. That's the definition of Bhagavad Gita. Okay? Now, why is it called song? It's a discussion, right, Mataji? Then why is it called song? Yes, Hridya? Was Krishna singing? No, right? Krishna was talking to Arjuna, right? Then why is it called song? You may have doubt. Okay? So, any scriptural authentic things are said in certain meter in Sanskrit. Okay? Every Ashtakams, every songs, every scriptures, Vedas, Upanishads, everything is spoken in Sanskrit, but different meters. Okay, that meter will show us, or we hear it, that meter as a song. That's the reason it's called as song of the God. Krishna is not singing a movie song in the battlefield, right? He's telling to Arjuna about his duty in a meter in Sanskrit, which is audible like a poem. P-O-E-M, poem you call, right? So it's called Bhagavad Gita, song of the God. Now, very important thing I'm going to tell you, okay? Please make notes, whoever can make notes, okay? Some of the kids know about this, but patiently listen. Rujula, you are able to understand, right? Whatever I'm speaking? Yes, okay. So, definition of Bhagavan. We gave the definition of Bhagavad Gita because we are reading Bhagavad Gita. But why we have to read Bhagavad Gita? Because Bhagavan is speaking. So, let's know the first of all, what is Bhagavan definition? Everybody will say Ganesha is a dog. I'm sorry. Ganesha is a god. Durga Devi is a god. Kali Mata is a god. Balaji is a god. Everybody is god. But why we have to listen only the sayings of, why is it so famous that we have to listen about Bhagavad Gita? What is the difference between other people's teachings and speaking, and what is the difference between Krishna's teachings? Okay, so Krishna is here mentioned as Bhagavan. Okay, any one of you have an idea of scriptural definition of Bhagavan? Who is God? There should be some idea of who is Srimati Mataji? Oh, Srimati Mataji is Veerabhadra Prabhu's wife, Rishika's mom, Shreya's mom, etc., etc., etc. But who is God? God should have a definition, right? Why Krishna is the only God? Does anybody know why Krishna is the God? Okay, Hridya, you can speak.
Because he's powerful?
He's powerful. Hridya covered one point. Very good, Hridya. Because he is powerful. I want five more points if anybody can cover. There are five more points. Powerful is the one point. Okay, Radhya? Unmute.
Everything.
He is everything, but you want to specifically say something? Hridya told he is powerful. You want to say something?
Yes.
Yes. You want to
be opulent?
Huh? Yes. Yes.
Opulences.
He has six opulences. Yes. Sreetan, you are right. But they are listing the opulences. Hridya told one opulence that he is most powerful. Radhya, you are saying something or no?
Krishna gives us everything.
Krishna gives you everything. Okay, good. Sreetan, you want to list one of the opulence? Hridya listed powerful. You want to tell anything?
Intellect.
You are saying intelligent? Okay, so he is the most intelligent kid. Second one is covered. There are six opulences which we are covering. Okay, and then I'll say why Krishna is Bhagavan. Keshav, you want to speak, tell something? Do you know anything about Krishna being the most? Yeah, Hridya, I know, but wait. We'll give the turn for everybody. Keshav. I can't hear you. Maybe you have to speak on your phone or something.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
I don't really know anything.
You know something?
Oh, I don't really know any of his opulences.
Yeah, powerful it's been said and intellect it's been said. Okay, Rujula. Rujula, come on. You have to unmute. Unmute. I can't hear you, Rujula, still. He's powerful, he's intelligent. Two things are told. What do you want to say? Krishna is what? I can't hear you, Rujula. Prabhuji, kuch volume ka gadbad hai. Baki sab bachcho ka mereko sunai de raha hai. Iska hi kam sunai de raha hai. Rujula, you want to say something, beta?
Rujula, Harpreet.
Rujula.
Krishna is the most beautiful.
Most beautiful, wonderful. 3 points covered. One is what Hridya told, he is most powerful. Second one is he is most intelligent, Sreetan told, and Rujula told he is most beautiful. Wonderful. 3 points already covered. Anybody wants to say, or you want me to list the remaining three? Krishna, you want to say something about Krishna? Satyabhama, you want to say something about Krishna?
I want to.
Yeah, Krishna, tell me.
He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yes, of course. That is the Bhagavan definition we are giving. Three opulences are covered, Krishna. Three more opulences are left. Very easy opulences. Opulence means the qualities of Krishna. So, intelligence is covered. Beauty is covered. Powerful is covered. Satyabhama, go ahead.
Beautiful.
Krishna, mute yourself. Krishna, mute. Okay, Satyabhama.
He was kind to all his friends he played with.
Okay, he was kind. Okay, we will add that, okay? His kindly nature also we will add. There are six, but we'll add this also, okay?
Mataji,
Krishna was very kind. Yeah.
He was kind to animals also.
Yeah, he was very kind to animals also.
And he didn't eat meat.
He didn't eat any meat. Okay, good. Okay, now I'll tell you. Beautiful is covered. Okay, powerful is covered. Okay, intelligence is covered. He's the most famous. Do you know that? We all want to be famous, right? I want to be famous. You want to be famous. Someone wants to be famous in astrology. Someone wants to be famous in painting. Someone wants to be famous in singing. Different hobbies, right? Everybody wants to be famous. But Krishna is the most famous personality. Vikram, sit. No problem. You can also hear. Okay, so Krishna is the most famous, okay? He is known by everyone, okay? Okay, next. Yes, somebody wants to speak?
I know one.
You know one? Go ahead.
Krishna is God because he is one of the reincarnations of Lord Vishnu.
Okay, here there is a point. Who spoke this?
Aditya.
Yeah, Aditya, we will come to this point. Krishna is, of course, as you are saying, came from Vishnu, as you have said. That's only in the Dwapara Yuga. But original Krishna, we will have a deeper discussion on this on the next class. What is the difference between Avatar Krishna and Avatari Krishna? There are two Krishnas here. One Krishna who is the supreme personality of the Godhead. The same personality of the Godhead came in his own form in Dwapara Yuga. That is the incarnation of Krishna. Okay? We will deal in detail with that. You are correct, but little more advanced way we will deal with this subject. Okay?
Very good. Thank you. Can I go?
Yeah, Bhuvan, go ahead.
So, yeah,
okay, I'll tell you what I'm...
It's just that...
Bhuvan?
Can I tell what I want? I'm guessing.
Ah, okay.
I'm not sure if this is correct, but I'll tell you, okay? So, Krishna is everywhere.
Krishna is everywhere, of course. You are right. You are right, Bhuvan. Krishna is everywhere. So, I'm listing the six opulence kids. Whoever wants to write, they can write, okay? We covered power, we covered fame, we covered beauty, we covered knowledge. There is full of, he is most wealthiest person. Krishna has so many wives. Every wife has a big palace. Every wife is the richest lady. Most richest, most wealthiest person, because everything comes from Krishna. Most knowledgeable, as intelligence has been already told. Vairagya, last one, most renounced personality. So, most wealthy, most strong, most famous, most beautiful, most knowledgeable, and most renounced. Who do not know what is renounced? And who knows what is renounced? Okay, let me see. Who knows? Then they can explain for the people who don't know. Renounce. Who know what is the meaning of renounce? Renunciation. It's okay if you don't know. I also did not know till I joined ISKCON. Don't worry. Okay, let me explain you. Renunciation means you have everything but you are not attached to anything. Suppose if you have a beautiful dress. Let's say beautiful dress for the girls and beautiful shoes for the boys. Okay? It's the best shoes you have. It's the best dress you have. Right? You have something. You own something. Right? So what's the next thing will happen? You are attached to that thing. This is mine. If I wear this, if I show this to everybody, everybody say it is beautiful, it is nice. Huh? This is called attachment. So Krishna has everything, but he is detached of everything. That's called renunciation. That's the most important quality which many of the other so-called demigods or gods don't have. They cannot be renounced. Unless Krishna is renounced, means he doesn't have any attachment, right, Vidya? If he had attachment to all his qualities, Radhya, he would not have drove the chariot of Arjuna. He would think that he is the biggest personality. He has everything, all the six opulences. Why he has to ride the chariot of Arjuna? He can call Arjuna to his office, come here, sit, we will have a conference. You sit down, I sit on the chair, I'll explain you, you listen and go and fight in the battlefield. No, he did not do that. He said that, let's go, I'll help you, I'm going to be your charioteer. And then he told, this is called renunciation. Nobody can be as renounced as Krishna. Because he has the most of everything, but still he is not attached. This is the quality of being renounced, renunciation. Okay, so these six qualities, if anybody has, he is mentioned as God. But there is no one listed in the scriptures other than Krishna having these six opulences. Yes, Vidya, is there anybody you know who have? Is there anybody who you know who has all these six opulences together? No, right? Nobody. All the qualities at the same time, he has forever these qualities. When he is a baby also, he had everything. When he was big also, he had everything. When he was baby also, he was as beautiful as when he was 16 years old. No difference. So all the qualities, at the same time, he possessed all the qualities all along his pastimes, whatever he did. Okay? Now, who knows the meaning of Krishna? We say, right, Krishna, 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 Krishna. Mom and dad, whenever they have anything, if they are getting up from the floor also standing, some people say Krishna. Yes, Pranav, Keshav. I can't hear you, Keshav. Unmute yourself first and then talk on the phone. First, yeah, now you speak.
No, still. Can you...
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Means black.
Krishna means black. Yes, Krishna is one of the name of black. Yes, Krishna is bluish black, so he is called Krishna also. Very good. Any other meanings, kids? Krishna. Bhuvan, you want to say the meaning of Krishna? Krishna, just to say Krishna. Okay, Krishna, can you tell the meaning of Krishna? Yes, it's your name, so you have to tell the right meaning now.
It means supreme personality of Godhead.
Yeah, Krishna is the supreme personality of the Godhead, but Krishna has a different, beautiful meaning. Now I'll tell you the meaning. So next time, whenever anybody asks what is the name of meaning of your name, you can say that. Aditya, do you want to tell the meaning of Krishna?
Yeah.
Tell, please.
Krishna means beautiful.
I'm waiting. You want to take a guess?
Krishna means beautiful, powerful, intellectual, and caring.
Those are the qualities, right? Krishna means powerful, right?
Yeah.
Exact meaning of the word Krishna means all attractive. All attractive. Krishna is all attractive. You can say beautiful also, but attractive, very attractive. Even the enemies of Krishna got attracted to Krishna. Kamsa got attracted to the beauty of Krishna. Rama means the pleasure giver. Yes? Satyabhama, you are there? You are understanding?
Yes.
the meaning of Krishna? Did you raise your hand when I asked? I don't know. I didn't see you on the screen, else I would have asked you. Krishna means all attractive, the most beautiful. Okay? So whenever, when you are reading about someone who has given Supreme Personality of the Godhead is excellent, he is the Supreme Personality of the Godhead, that's the reason we are all hearing about what he has said. But actual meaning of Krishna is all attractive. I'll give you the other meaning also, because someone can ask me, what is the meaning of Arjuna, Mataji? If Krishna is all attractive, what is Arjuna? Does anybody have a guess of what is the meaning of Arjuna?
Arjuna is the opposite of Krishna.
No, he is not the opposite of Krishna. How can he be the opposite of Krishna?
I said white.
You are right in that way. Yes. Yes, Rithan, you are right in that way. Black and white, he is right. Yes, Krishna is black, bluish black. Arjuna is white. Yes, you are right. I agree that point. But Arjuna literally means silver color or clear. He is very clear. He is very shiny. Krishna is also shiny in bluish black form. But as you have said, in one way we can take the definition of black is Krishna and white is Arjuna. But you should not say opposite to Krishna, okay? If you say opposite to Krishna, that becomes like Krishna is very good and Arjuna is very bad. Opposite comes the word wherein the characters are displayed. Like Kamsa and Krishna are opposite to each other, we can say, because Krishna is the person who is very righteous and Kamsa is not a righteous person. So that becomes an opposite. But colors wise, yes, Krishna is bluish black and Arjuna is very fair, white, silverish, clear. Basically, his character is also white. Two personalities in Mahabharata are told to be very clear in their character. And they were also always white. Can you guess the second character in Mahabharata? Who is like clear, who is like very... by nature he is very, very... I'm sorry?
Is he Yudhishthira?
Yudhishthira can be, but there is one other personality, elderly personality.
Dronacharya or Bhishma.
Dronacharya. Bhishmacharya. Not Dronacharya, but Bhishmacharya. Bhishma Dev. You all know, right? Bhishma Dev, who is the grandfather of the whole Kuru dynasty. Kuru dynasty is... Now we will discuss more little bit about who are there in this Bhagavad Gita, right? Pandavas are there, Kauravas are there, right? Now note it down, kids. Kuru dynasty means Pandavas and Kauravas together are called Kuru dynasty. Yes? Satyabhama, Hridya, everybody. So if somebody says who are Kurus, you should not say Kurus are only Kauravas. No. Kuru is a dynasty which has both Pandavas and Kauravas. Okay? Pandavas got their name Pandavas because they are the sons of King Pandu. Okay? Pandavas are how many? Hridya, how many Pandavas? Hridya.
Five Pandavas and 100 Kauravas.
Five Pandavas, good. Rujula, how many Kauravas?
101 Kauravas.
Very good, 101. Who is going to tell me the name of 101th Kaurava? 100 Kauravas we all know. Satyabhama, do you know who is the 101 character in Kauravas? 100 sons and one daughter, right? Do you know who she is? Pratibhama, do you know the sister of Kauravas? There is one sister of Kauravas. Duryodhana, Dushyasana, total 100, right? There is one sister also in Kauravas. 100 brothers and one sister. Do you know the name? Satyabhama? You don't know? That's okay. I also didn't know before. Does anybody know? Bhuvan, do you know the sister of Kauravas? Okay, you don't know. Who know? Who is that?
Aditya.
Aditya, who is the sister of Kauravas?
Dushala.
Dushala, very good. That's the right answer. Dushala is the sister of Kauravas. That makes 100 Kauravas 101. So Kauravas were 100, Satyabhama, 100 brothers. And Pandavas were only 5. Okay, Satyabhama will name all the 5 Pandavas. Satyabhama, can you name the Pandavas? Okay, let's try. 1 name, 2 name, 3 name. How many you can try, you can tell.
Sure.
Bhima,
okay, Bhima.
Bhima, Arjuna. And I only know two.
You only know two. No problem. Vidya.
Bhima, Arjun, Sahadev, Yudhishthir, and Bhima.
Last, Sahadev's brother, another brother of Sahadev. What is the name? Bhima, Arjuna. Okay, Aditya, who is the last one? Vidya is missing one.
Nakula.
Nakula, done. Five brothers, okay? Nakula, Sahadeva, Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna. So remember like this, kids. Yudhishthira is the eldest. Bhima, second eldest. Arjuna, third. Nakula and Sahadeva, fourth and fifth. Okay? So now there is a little thing what you have to understand. Yudhishthira, Bhima and Arjuna are King Pandu and Kunti's sons. But Nakula and Sahadeva are Pandu and, who knows the name of Nakula and Sahadeva? Yes, Hridya.
Ganda. No, no.
Pandu's second wife.
Madri.
Madri. Madri. Right. Who told that? Shritan, did you tell that? Okay, Madri, yeah. Madri's sons are Nakula and Sahadeva. So these five brothers are in the Pandavas team. Okay? And many others are there, of course. Okay? Whole team is there. Big army is there. Akshayanis, it's called. Okay? And Kaurava's team had 100 brothers along with other friends, all the kingdom people and everybody, everybody. What is the most prominent thing with Pandavas is they have Krishna with them, which Kauravas don't have. Okay? So Pandavas are in the battlefield with Krishna guarding them. Yes? Radhika, Hamsika, you are understanding? They have the full shelter of Krishna. Krishna is going to guide them at every point. Okay? In case of Kauravas, they are fully dependent on Bhishma and Dronacharya. Okay? Yes, Satyavama, speak.
Yudhishthira was supposed to be the king, but Dhritarashtra banished them from the kingdom and set their city on flames.
Yeah, yeah. Why did the war happen? Satyavama is explaining us why did the war happen. Yudhishthira was supposed to be the king, but Dhritarashtra wanted Duryodhana to be the king. That's the reason the whole war happened. Yudhishthira is the eldest, Pandu's son. He is supposed to be the king. But the blind king Dhritarashtra was there and he wanted his son to be the king. So they didn't want to give the kingdom to anybody. Okay? So they banished them. Yeah, banishing. That's again Mahabharat story. Thank you, Subhadra. Sorry, Satyabhama. See, I'm remembering Subhadra now. Yeah. Tell me, Aditya.
Sometimes my family and I are watching Mahabharata a little bit later.
You're not watching, only your family is watching. Also watch with them?
Yeah, I also watch with them, but it's like in Hindi and I also ask my mom or dad.
It's good to watch other languages also, especially Hindi kids with the English subtitles down, because that way you can learn Hindi also. You know Rishika Didi and Shreyas, right? They learned Hindi completely by watching the Mahabharat, Ramayana, Hindi, God movies, everything on TV with the subtitles. We never taught them Hindi, but they can speak very nicely Hindi and understand Hindi very nicely. So you can watch the Hindi videos of Krishna, Rama and all those things. That's very good. Okay, so this Bhagavad Gita is how old? Who knows? How old is Bhagavad Gita? Hridya is 8 years old, 7 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old, right? Yes, Hridya.
I'm not 6 or 7, I'm 5.
No, I'm just telling. I'm asking you, Hridya, do you know how old is Bhagavad Gita?
I can have a guess.
Okay.
100.
Huh? 100 years old? Wait. Wait, hold on. Hridya is speaking.
1000
years old. Okay. 1000 is 1000, right? So,
but
okay,
let's see. Even older?
Radhika,
I know. That was a yuga ago. That was almost a yuga ago.
Yuga ago? Okay, Shritan. I'll tell you how old it is. Radhika, you have a guess?
5000.
Okay. Radhika, you have a guess? Yeah, I'll ask you. You also said 5000. Okay, Krishna, tell me, how old?
I know how old it is.
Krishna, tell me.
5000.
5000, very good. Who else has how many guesses? Is anything different from what we heard? Somebody told 5000, somebody told 10,000, 10,000, somebody told 500. Okay. So, the closest answer what we see here is 5000 years old. Okay. But Satyabhama, Bhagavad Gita doesn't have an age. Yeah, go ahead, Satyabhama. You want to speak? Yes,
Satyabhama. Krishna read about Bhagavad Gita before everyone was born.
Yeah, before everyone was born, right.
So, I have a question.
Yes, go ahead.
I forgot it.
You forgot it. Okay, when you remember again, you can ask me. Okay, everybody listen carefully. Rujula, Radhika, Hansika, Krishna, everybody listen carefully. Bhagavad Gita is eternal. Krishna is eternal. Krishna's teachings are eternal. Bhagavad Gita doesn't have any age. If you ask Krishna is how old, and we will do one more last thing after this is, we will learn a prayer which has a complete meaning about what is Krishna. Anyhow, so Bhagavad Gita is eternal. Bhagavad Gita doesn't have any age. Krishna doesn't have any age in the same way. Aditya, you want to speak something? There is a raised hand. No? Okay. Okay, no? Okay, that's fine. So, Bhagavad Gita, as such, we know, is spoken by Krishna 5,000 years back. Aditya was saying few minutes back that Krishna is the reincarnation of Lord Vishnu. This is related to this something. Krishna came as Krishna 5,000 years back, but Krishna is always eternal in the Goloka. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of the Godhead. Krishna gave the job of creation, maintenance and destruction to different personalities. One of them is Vishnu. In the process of maintenance, Vishnu has come in the form of 10 incarnations, out of which one was again Krishna, which is called as Purna Purushottam Avatar. But Vishnu himself comes from the Supreme Personality of the Godhead, Krishna. So there is the distinction between the whole Krishna and the incarnation Krishna. What we all know is Krishna is only 5,000 years old. Because Krishna came 5,000 years old, right?
Mataji,
yes,
Vidya.
How
old is Krishna even?
Krishna is eternal. Krishna doesn't have an age. Krishna was there when everybody was born before also. Krishna will be there after everybody leaves their body also. Shritan, what?
Did you see the Madhavan fact that was about Krishna save?
I'm not understanding you, Shritan.
I sent a message in chat that was about Lord Krishna's heirs.
Oh, I'm not seeing the messages, Shritan. I cannot manage messages and videos both. I'm seeing some messages, but I'm not reading. I'll read it later. Lord Krishna is younger than the youngest and older than the oldest. Yes, very good. Very good, Shritan. Our prayer, what we are going to learn now, speaks about this. Okay? Krishna is extreme of everything. He can be anything. Okay? In this whole creation, everything is Krishna and Krishna's. Janki, it's not your brother Krishna, it's Lord Krishna, okay? Don't think that it Krishna means everything is your brother's, okay? I'm just kidding. Okay, so everything is Lord Krishna and Krishna's. There is nothing which is not Krishna or Krishna's. This table is not Krishna, but table is Krishna's. This book is not Krishna, but it is Krishna's. But there are something which is Krishna himself also. Krishna is Krishna himself. Krishna's incarnations are Krishna himself. So Krishna and Krishna's everything is. So Krishna is the oldest. So Krishna is not 5,000 years old, because we all think that Krishna came in Dwapar Yuga, so Krishna is 5,000 years old. No. Krishna told this Bhagavad Gita to someone else also. And he says that to Arjuna. Who knows about that? Whom did he tell about? He says to Arjuna that, hey Arjuna, this is not first time I'm giving you this knowledge. I have given this knowledge to someone else also previously. Who knows that? Shritan, Keshav, anybody know? Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita very clearly.
He gave it to the sun god and then...
Yes, Shritan, you are right. He gave this knowledge before also to the sun god, Krishna says. So this knowledge is not the new knowledge. This knowledge was already spoken before the Bhagavad Gita was spoken in the battlefield. But due to the time, lot of time passed by and the knowledge got lost. So Krishna has to establish or re-establish this knowledge through Arjuna.
Okay.
Got it? Everybody got it? Now we are going to do a prayer. Okay? Repeat after me as if, as you hear from me. Many of you know this prayer, but whoever don't know, follow me slowly. Okay? And this I'm going to send in the group which you can memorize the meaning and also the prayer. Because every time we start the class, we are going to do this prayer. Okay? Okay, everybody can unmute if you want, or if you don't want to unmute also, you need not unmute. It's up to you, your convenience, okay? Ishvara Parama Krishna.
Parama Krishna.
Satchidananda Vigraha. Whoever can speak nicely can unmute. Satyabhama, unmute chesi, repeat chai. Ishvara Parama Krishna.
Mataji, I know this.
Ishvara Parama Krishna.
Ishvara Parama Krishna.
Satchidananda Vigraha.
Satchidananda Vigraha.
Anadir Adir Govinda.
Anadir Adir Govinda.
Sarva Karana Karanam.
Sarva Karana Karanam.
Very good. I like Radhika and Hansika folding their hands when they are doing this prayer. That's good. Every time you do this prayer, you have to fold your hands. Radhya also fold her hands. This is a prayer. Bhuvan also folded his hands. Very good. This is a prayer which we are glorifying Krishna. Now I'm going to tell the meaning of this prayer, kids. Okay, everybody mute your calls. I don't want any sound, please. Okay, so I'm going to tell the meaning of this prayer. Because unless and until you know the clear meaning of something, there is no much use of reciting that prayer. Yes? If you say chocolate, 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 and you don't know what is chocolate, how do you understand what you are speaking? Right? If a small baby who has just learned how to talk and she never has seen a chocolate, you tell to her chocolate, if she just says chocolate, does she understand anything by chocolate? No. Because she has never seen chocolate, never tasted chocolate, right? So any prayer what you do, you should know the meaning of that prayer, okay? Vidya, you said that you know this prayer. Let's see if you know the meaning of the prayer also. Let's try. Ishvara Parama Krishna, who can tell me this line meaning? There are three words in this line. Ishvara, Parama, Krishna.
Mataji, Krishna means like Krishna himself.
Yeah, Krishna means Krishna himself. Yes, of course, Krishna. Ishvara, Parama, Krishna. Who is telling the meaning of these three words in the one line? Yes, Ridhya, go ahead. You're on.
I'll try to give a guess. What Krishna said...
Krishna said what? Krishna Uvacha then. Bhagavan Uvacha that is. Okay. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Satyabhama, you want to take a try? What is Ishvara Parama Krishna? Krishna should tell this because Krishna told before this five times the meaning of this thing. Satyabhama, you know Ishvara Parama Krishna means what? Yes? No?
I know only one word.
That Which
was
one?
Word.
Huh?
That was the last word.
Krishna? Okay, you know only Krishna. Okay, no problem.
Krishna himself and also Vishnu himself.
Krishna himself. Okay. Krishna, where are you? You tell me who is Krishna. Then that meaning will be covered here.
He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
You got it. You got it. He has been saying this from the start class. Now you got the right answer for the right question. Okay. Ishvara Parama Krishna means? Krishna means Krishna. Ishvara Parama. Ishvara means? Personality of Godhead. Parama means Supreme. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of the Godhead. This is the meaning. Ishvara, Parama, Krishna. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of the Godhead. That's the first line. Ishvara, Parama, Krishna. Next comes second line. Okay, everybody knows the second line. Bhuvan, Sat, Chit, Ananda, Vigraha, right? Sat, Chit, Ananda, Vigraha. Right, Bhuvan? You know the meaning of what is Sat, Chit, Ananda, Vigraha? You want to take a guess? You know the Sat, Chit, Ananda meaning, Bhuvan? No? Okay, no problem. I'll explain you. Okay, who else? Who wants to take the guess of Sat, Chit, Ananda? Radhya, you know Sat, Chit, Ananda?
No.
No, Mataji? Okay, no problem. Aditya, you know the meaning, Sat, Chit, Ananda?
Yes.
Can you tell me what is Sat, Chit, Ananda?
Pure joy.
I'm sorry?
Pure joy.
Joy I could get. Another word, what did you say?
Pure.
Pure?
P-U-R-E.
Pure. Okay, pure. Okay. Pure is there, but different meaning is there. You told the meaning of the Ananda. Two words are there. You covered one word meaning. Remaining two I'll tell you. Okay, who else? Shritan and Keshav. Pranav, anybody wants to take a guess of Sat and Chit?
I can.
Okay, hold on. Let's give a try for Rujula. Rujula, tell me.
Always happy.
Always happy, yes. That's Ananda. Thank you. And who said Shritan? You said you want to say? Who wanted to say? Keshav, did you want to say Sat and Chit?
Me.
Okay, Hridya.
Krishna is so powerful.
Powerful? Okay. Sat and Chit. Exact meanings I need. Do you want to say, Keshav? Yes or no?
Yeah, I'll say.
Okay. Sat means what?
I think Sat means the real. It means the only real thing.
You're close. Sat means eternal. Which exists always. Sun exists always. Moon exists always. Which exists?
I don't know what.
Yeah, eternal. Sat means eternal. Okay, note it down. Whoever wants to note it down. Three words. Sat means eternal. Chit means knowledge. Ananda means bliss or happiness. Sat, Chit, Ananda. So second line means Sat Chit Ananda Vigraha. Vigraha means embodiment. Embodiment means all these three things in one personality. That's Sat Chit Ananda Vigraha. Second line is done. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Right, Radhya, you know the prayer, right? Ishvara Parama Krishna Sat Chit Ananda Vigraha. Right? Third line is coming. Satya Bhama. Your daddy is not teaching you. I am teaching you. Turn this side. Third line. Anadir Adir Govinda. Here comes the point of Shritan. Oldest of the older of the oldest. Younger than the youngest. Older than the oldest. Anadir Adir Govinda. He was there before everything started. He is the primeval. And he is the youngest of the youngest also. Anadir Adir Govinda. Who knows the meaning of Govinda? We all know Krishna as Govinda, right? Govinda, 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 we say, right? What does Govinda mean? Who knows the meaning? Radhika, Hansika, Shritan, Keshav, Pranav. Okay, Radhika.
Savior of cows.
What cows?
Savior of cows.
Very good. Savior of cows. One of the meaning of Govinda. Bhuvan, you want to say something? Bhuvan.
It means into of the cows or into of everything.
Yeah. Exactly. Cows, related to cows. Go means. There is one other important meaning. Who wants to say? Go means cow and also another one. Yes, Kesha?
Savior of souls.
Savior of the souls. Yes, he is. But here, go means one other meaning. Yes, he is the savior of the souls. Very good, Keshav. One more, I want exact meaning. Okay, I'll let you know. Okay, note it down. Go means senses also. Govinda means one who is the caretaker of the cows. And Govinda also means one who is the controller of the senses. Go means senses also. You all know the senses. Yes, Pranav? Yes? You know the senses, right? Smell, touch, feel, all the five senses, gross senses. So Krishna is not only the controller of the gross, but also the subtle senses. He is also known as Govinda for that reason also. So everybody knows, if ever anybody asks what is Govinda, everybody will say it's related to cows. He's the protector of the cows, he's the savior of the cows, he's the lover of the cows, he's always with the cows, etc., etc., etc. But another internal meaning is go means senses also. So Arjuna's senses were bewildered, were going here and there. I don't want to fight for this reason, I don't want to fight for that reason, I don't want to fight. His senses are going everywhere. And Krishna controls Arjuna's senses by giving the detailed explanation. Yes? So Krishna is known as Govinda. Yes? So we can end today's class here with few last little bit noting down things. Okay? So many of you know. Okay, Radhya, how many chapters are there in Bhagavad Gita? Do you know how many chapters, Radhya?
18.
Who said that? Pranav said that, okay. Pranav, Sreetan, good. Radhya, did
you... number of chapters, Damodar Prasad memorized.
Okay. Radhya, did you want to speak something? Did you know how many chapters were there? 18 chapters, okay? 18 chapters in Bhagavad Gita, okay? You can remember from now, okay? There are total 18 chapters. Bhuvan, now kids whom I'm asking, they can answer. Bhuvan, how many verses are there in the 18 chapters? Only Bhuvan.
As someone else said in this classroom, there's 700.
Yeah, 700 verses. Bhuvan, you speak very, very nicely, huh? As someone else has said already in the class. Very nice. I like it. Yeah. If they said or not said also, it is 700 verses. Krishna did not speak everything, but total verses in Bhagavad Gita are 700. So, one more question I'm going to ask, and I'm going to name the student and ask. Okay? Sreetan, how many people are involved in the Bhagavad Gita conversation? Total, how many characters are involved in Bhagavad Gita?
This meeting?
Sreetan.
Is it this meeting?
No, not meeting. In the whole Bhagavad Gita, when Bhagavad Gita was spoken, who and all were there? In this meeting, I know, 12 or 13, but yeah.
Arjuna, Krishna, Dhritarashtra, Sanjaya, all the Kauravas, Pandavas, the soul.
You are right in one way, but that line ends till Dhritarashtra. All others are there, but they are not involved. Yudhishthira doesn't know what is happening. Yudhishthira was not there next to Arjuna to hear what Krishna was telling, right? So there were only four personalities involved. Note it down, kids. Krishna. Yes, Radhya? Four personalities are involved. Krishna, Arjuna, Sanjaya and Dhritarashtra, right? Bhagavad Gita starts with the first verse by Dhritarashtra, his inquiry. So in whole Bhagavad Gita, how many verses did Dhritarashtra speak? Guess? Anybody guess? Dhritarashtra spoke how many verses? Only one. Yes, Radhya. Yes, Keshav. Good. Only one verse was spoken Masiji? By Dhritarashtra. Yes. Masiji,
why did Dhritarashtra only sing one verse? Why not?
Yeah, because he don't know anything, Radhya. He is a blind king. He is sitting there and he want to know what is happening in the battlefield. He did not go to the battlefield, okay? He did not go to the battlefield. As you are sitting in your room, he was sitting in his palace nicely, in his private room. And his secretary Sanjaya was explaining what is happening in the battlefield. Okay? Now the story, kids. How does Sanjaya know what is happening in the battlefield?
I know. I think I can have a guess.
Yeah, tell me,
Riddhi.
Yes, special eyes. Yes. Riddhi, tell me, you wanted to speak something?
Yeah, I wanted to say, like, maybe Sanjaya, went to the battlefield and then...
Yeah. Sanjaya did not go to the battlefield. Sanjaya was the secretary of Dhritarashtra and he was sitting in the same palace room, private palace room, whatever, that Dhritarashtra was singing. Then how can Sanjaya see what is happening in battlefield? As Sridhar has said, he has special eyes, Radhya. Special eyes means not different from our eyes, but those eyes are given a special vision, okay? Divine vision, okay? In Sanskrit, it's called Divya Drishti, divine vision, okay? So Radhya is sitting in her room and drawing something, but she can see what is happening live in Srimati Mataji's house here in the room. Here in Srimati Mataji's room, there is a wall, there is a window, there is Mataji sitting. She's seeing live whatever is happening. She's not with me, but she knows what I am speaking, what I am moving. My right hand is moving, my left hand is moving. Mataji is singing, Mataji is speaking. She can see that, right? But Sanjaya didn't have anything live like that. But Sanjaya had a Divya Drishti or divine vision. Okay? With that divine vision, Sanjaya was seeing everything live telecast. You see the live telecast, right? Football match going on somewhere, soccer going on somewhere, and you see all live matches here. People are fighting somewhere, that's live recording is going on. Right now, I am speaking live to you and you are able to see, right? So in the same way, Sanjaya was seeing live what is happening in the battlefield. Got it, Radhya? Someone can ask you, how does Sanjaya know what is happening in the battlefield? So Satyabhama, you have to say that Sanjaya got this divine vision. Rujula, do you know who gave this divine vision to Sanjaya?
Wait, Sridhar.
Rujula, do you know?
Krishna?
In one way Krishna, but actually it is Vyasadev. Vyasadev is the teacher of Sanjaya. So that Vyasadev gave this divine vision to Sanjaya. So that he can see whatever is happening in the battlefield. He is the spiritual master. He is the teacher of Sanjaya. So Sanjaya got this divine vision through which Sanjaya was able to see everything. Sanjaya was like Arjuna standing before Krishna and listening everything. Sanjaya also was listening everything. Sanjaya was listening what Arjuna is speaking. Sanjaya was listening what Krishna is speaking. Sanjaya was listening what Duryodhana's Dhritarashtra's questions were. So Sanjaya is very, very important character here. He is kind of narrator for us all about what is happening in the battlefield. Because Krishna did not narrate as Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna did not narrate as Bhagavad Gita. We are hearing the narration by Sanjaya to Dhritarashtra. We all are hearing through the Bhagavad Gita. One last 1 minute notable points here. Okay. How many verses are spoken by Krishna out of the 700? Who knows? Raise their hand. There are 700 verses, right? Krishna, what happened to your video? Hridya, tell me how many verses by Krishna out of 700? Take a guess.
500?
Close! You are very close. Okay? Anybody? Now wait. Who else want to take a guess?
I'll try.
Okay.
550?
550 is very close. Very, very close. Very, very close.
540?
No, up. Up. Krishna. Krishna, you have to be right. Because Krishna has spoken, Krishna is speaking now. How many verses? Take a guess, close guess to whatever the highest number told already. Krishna, I can't hear you. Nahi, unmute karo pehle. Mute it.
540.
Okay, I said more than the highest number. Okay, let me tell you, everybody note it down. 574 verses. Now you have to do your math. 574 verses, note it down. Krishna spoke 574 verses out of the 700 verses. Arjuna spoke 84 verses. How many remaining out of 700? 42 remaining. So one verse was spoken by Dhritarashtra. So how many remaining? 41. So who spoke the 41 verses? Sanjaya. 574 by Krishna, 84 by Arjuna, 41 by Sanjaya, and one verse by Dhritarashtra. This is the whole figure of 700 verses spoken in Bhagavad Gita. Okay, so just summarizing what we studied today, we studied the definition of Bhagavad Gita, we studied the definition of Bhagavan, we studied who are the characters involved in Bhagavad Gita, who the war is happening in between, total number of verses in Bhagavad Gita, total number of chapters in Bhagavad Gita, who and all spoke how many verses. We studied about the most important prayer, which we all will do every week in the class, and I'm going to send the audio, I'm going to send the lyrical and the meaning of that particular prayer. Ishvara Paramakrishna Sachidananda Vikra Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam, last line, fourth line, Sarva Karana Karanam. He is the cause of all causes. Krishna is the cause of all causes. Okay, so four lines in one verse. I'll send everything on WhatsApp. Shritan, are you added in the group?
What group?
Can I know your mom's name?
Shritan?
Yes?
Deepika Mataji.
Oh, Deepika Mataji's son, not Shritan. Oh, okay, okay, okay. I was guessing whose son. Okay, good, good. How is your sister and everybody doing? Yes, someone is speaking? Okay.
Yeah.
Who is this?
Krishna.
Yeah, Krishna, tell me.
How many verses did Arjuna speak?
Arjuna spoke 84 verses. 84.
And Sanjay
spoke 41 verses. Okay. 574, 84, 41 and 1.
Thank you, Mataji.
You are welcome. Keshav, what is that? Hold on.
41.
Can you repeat that? So.
Okay. Krishna spoke 574 verses, Arjuna spoke 84 verses, Sanjaya spoke 41 verses, Dhritarashtra 1 verse, 700 verses. Okay. Don't ask me this question again next week. I might forget, okay? 574, 84, 41 and 1, 700 in total. Okay, everybody fine with the class? Everybody happy with the class?
Yeah.
Everybody will join next week in the class?
Yes.
You like the class, Krishna?
Yes.
Rujula, you like the class? Okay. Radhika, Hansika?
Yeah.
Boom, you are okay?
I like it.
You liked it. Okay, you liked it. Satyabhama?
That's why I put my thumbs up. See?
I liked it so much.
Yeah. You like it? Okay, your thumb is up. Very nice, Vidya. Radhya, did you like the class? You want to attend next week the class? Yes? Okay. So we will take leave. Pranav, you are okay? Everything fine? You like it? Too? Little bit? That's okay. We are all new. Don't worry. We will all learn together. Next week, I'll tell you how our class structure will be, how we will try to know what Krishna is telling to Arjuna and everything. Okay? Thank you very much, everyone. Anybody has any doubts? Anybody wants to speak? All are okay?
I agree.
What happened, Vidya?
Nothing, I just agree.
Okay. Thank you, kids. Okay. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Bol. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare
Krishna. Bye. See you, Aditya. Hansika. Krishna. Hridya. Bye. Rujula. See you. Bhuvan. Hare Bol. Aditya. See you. Radhya. See you. Krishna. Hare Bol.
Bye.
See you, Aditya. Hare Krishna.
Goodbye.
Bye.
How is it?
Just good. So many kids attended.
Mm-hmm. Except Govinda didn't.
That's great. You want to message us?